beneath a myrtle shade, which love for none but happy lovers made, I slept. And straight my love before me brought Phyllis, the object of my waking thought. Undressed she came my flames to meet, while love strode flowers beneath her feet, flowers which so pressed by her became more sweet. From the bright vision's head, a careless veil of lawn was loosely spread. From her white temples fell her shaded hair, like cloudy sunshine, not too brown nor fair. Her hands, her lips, did love inspire. Her every grace my heart did fire. But most her eyes, which languished with desire.
Ah, charming fair, said I, how long can you my bliss and yours deny? By nature and by love, this lonely shade was for revenge of suffering lovers made. Silence and shades with love agree, both shelter you and favor me. You cannot blush because I cannot see.
No, let me die, she said, rather than lose the spotless name of maid.
Faintly, methought, she spoke, for all the while she bid me not believe her with a smile. Then die, said I.
She's still denied, and is it thus, 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 she cried, you use a harmless maid?
And so she died.
I waked.
And straight I knew, I loved so well, it made my dream prove true. Fancy, the kinder mistress of the two, Fancy had done what Phyllis would not do. Ah, cruel nymph, cease your disdain, while I can dream you scorn in vain. Asleep or waking, you must ease my pain.